the timing whereby you finish campaigning on a Thursday night and get the result on a Saturday night is absolutely brutal. I think all of the candidates would share that. So I just want to say thank you to begin with to everyone, Tim, you and your team, who have put this election together in a huge election, four elections, but in the face of some extraordinary challenges as well, particularly obviously COVID. So thank you all for all the effort that's gone in. For my part, I just want to thank everyone who's worked on the team. Hayley's obviously been an anchor as well from Region Office, so thank you. But everyone's put in the hours, volunteers. This is where I know that I will get off the stage and think, who did I not thank? And I'll get texts saying you didn't thank this person and that person. Sorry, my apologies in advance for that. But for all those people who have really put in the hours on the campaign, it just would have been possible without you. And from the very personal support as well from the councillors that were really close around me, Mark, Helen, Craig, Kai. Now I'm not going to mention people, but there's lots of people. I also need to thank the candidates. People will often look at politicians and like we know it happens, you somehow cross this line and cease to be a rounded human being with many aspects to what you are and just become a politician. And it's a brutal process. While Sandy's been on this for 2 years, Alistair, more recently, obviously, and the same with Caroline and some of the other candidates. But to be on this treadmill for such a long time, anticipating an election when you think every mistake you make could be recorded, photographed, tweeted, in which people are forensically examining who you are, what they think you are, projecting what they want you to be as well, which may not have anything to do with who you actually are, is exhausting. And my respect goes to anyone that crosses the line. On that front. And I should do also, thank my wife, Kirsten, who's trying to FaceTime this right now. again, we never cease to be fully rounded human beings with children, with work, with pressures, with concerns, with nerves, and all the other things that go on in everyday life. And people don't often see that side of political existence, but my wife has to put up with me and put up with the challenges of me being there. And dare I say, actually, I've all shared, because I think we should set a standard, when people write things like, we know where you live, it's my Wi-Fi off the phone, right? So we have to think about the way we do politics and the quality of our political discourse. And I should also have to thank those people that voted for me, obviously. Thank you so much. It's always a very humbling thing, and it's almost an otherworldly thing to meet someone that says, I voted for you. This happened over the last few weeks when you see people on the street and they said, I've put my postal vote and I've got a few already. That's incredibly humbling. And like I said, it's another world where it's an out-of-body experience almost, to think that someone trusts you with the city. Just a few other things. This is my old school as well, which I didn't even make the connection until I was on my way down here. I came here between 1883 and 1990. And I was on the SWU, SWU FM the other day with a guy called Joe Payne from Late Black, and he said, we were rugrats coming out of this part of the city. How did you become men? and I suppose there's something nice and poetic for me in that I take this re-election in the school that I struggled at, that wasn't always fun, that we faced all these challenges, that many some of the kids I went to school with and no longer with us and all the rest of it. And this is the school, and I hope that one of the messages that can come out from this is there is hope, right? Where you come from, it ain't a fair world. You live in one of the most socially immobile countries in the OECD, right? Where your parental wealth is the biggest determinant of your life chances. But there can be hope in the middle of all that, and that's what we've tried to set ourselves out to do as an administration. The other piece of poetry, actually, was that when I decided to run in 2012, I gave an assembly in this very hall who the heck is this guy stepping up to run for mayor? And those seatings were pulled out. There was a school assembly, and I came here to launch my 2012 campaign to the kids, two kids in my old school. And I said, I went to your school, and I'm running for mayor today, right? I didn't know how far it would go, but that was from the very beginning of what to say. That's what this is about. Look at this pathway. I'm not claiming to be anything special. But I grew up down the road, I went to Eastern Road, after I went to St. Nick's and it didn't quite work out. And then I came here, and then I made it, I got to sixth form, just about 5 C's at GCSE, that's all I got. I just scraped my way through. So I hope that maybe today there's a piece of poetry that people can draw on. I think too, for me, it is a moment of great joy, obviously, and may not look like it. It's qualified until I see what happens with my councillors. I have some fantastic councillors, I've worked with in the city, and I'm desperately hoping that they get elected as well. I think it came to me as a challenge, but I think it's true that getting elected first time is one thing, getting re-elected is something of a whole different order. And I suppose part of the blessing of being re-elected is an affirmation that people like what we've been doing. Some people don't, but on the whole, and for some people that couldn't elect as well, like the way we've tried to lead the city, we tried to be inclusive, we focused on our delivering social justice in the face of climate and ecological emergencies. And so we'll continue, continue in that vein. And last but not least, I'd just like to say something very personal. I lost my brother in December. And I dreamed that if I was to win, I'd be able to stand on stage and just say, Martin, you'll never be forgotten to me. And I hope that something of this victory is part of